All right, I'm Anna Galletly, and I'm about to start the nervous system series of video lectures for AMP1 Lab. This first one is going to focus on nervous tissue itself. All right, as usual, you will find the note slides that I have included. So you can read these, and you don't need me to read them to you. All right, this slide, we are looking at a giant multipolar neuron. This one is taken from your APR slides. And what you'll notice is this general background. And this is your extracellular fluid, or your interstitial fluid, or your interstitium. And in this, you're going to have all of the other stuff floating in it. So you're going to see a lot of purple dots. Those are all going to be various glial cells. Now, at this level, I'm not asking you to differentiate the glial cells. It's probably mostly astrocytes, but you should at least be able to identify the purple dots as glial cells. Now, this is your giant multipolar neuron right here, and you'll notice that it's big. You actually are not seeing the entire thing. Most of the cytoplasmic processes actually go off the screen, okay, as this extends to different areas of the body, okay, or of the brain or the spinal cord or whatever. This area in here, all of this is called the cell body. That's the bulk. That's kind of like, you can think of that as the brain of your neuron. You'll see in the very center, the nucleus, all of this is nasal bodies, and this nucleolus region that surrounds the nucleus. The cytoplasmic processes, these are going to be dendrites and an axon. Now, again, at this level and at this magnification, it's really difficult to distinguish them, which is why I'm using just the phrase cytoplasmic process for this situation. All right, so now on this side, I have 1, 2, 3 pictures of nervous tissue. And you can see here is a giant multipolar neuron, here's another one, and you can see it's got its cytoplasmic processes going off of it, okay? Over here on number 3, you see some cytoplasmic processes, you've got some glial cells, and then all of this is your interstitium or your extracellular fluid. Now this one is addressing this question, okay? 1, 2, and 3 is all nervous tissue. This is a realer connective tissue proper. And I have it up here because it is really commonly mixed up with the nervous tissue because of all the lines and the dots. So you have, again, your ground substance, which is similar to the interstitium. So this is the ground substance. You've got lines. The dark ones are elastic fibers. The peak ones are collagen fibers, okay? And then you've got cells, which are gonna be fibroblasts, macrophages, and maybe some other things, okay? So what you want to do is focus on how these things are different. So like with a realer, you've got 2 different colored fibers. The cells are bigger, all right? Whereas here, the glial cells, they're a little bit smaller than what you would see, okay? And the shading, the way it's absorbing the stain, is a little different. All right, let's look at the basic anatomy of a neuron. So this is a multipolar neuron, like what we were looking at, all right? And you can see that right here, that's from the previous page. So this is the cell body or the soma, which is correlating to this structure over here. And then I've got these dendrites coming off, okay? Which is gonna be some of these cytoplasmic processes. I don't know which one for sure is an axon versus a dendrite, but you get the idea. Now you've got the nucleus here, and then this region right in here is called the axon hillock. This is where you're going to generate action potentials, okay? And then the tail is the axon. So one of these cytoplasmic processes would be an axon, okay? And down at the end of the axon, you have little feet, which are called axonal terminals. All right, and this is where you're going to release a neurotransmitter. Now you'll notice that the axon looks kind of like a string of pearls, and I've got all these white beads. Those are Schwann cells, and in between each Schwann cell is a node of Ranvier. Okay? Now, the Schwann cells in the peripheral nervous system create the myelin sheath. In the central nervous system, we use oligodendrocytes instead. All right, moving on to the next slide. All right, the previous slide will have had a my notes on myelination and what a myelin sheath is. I'm going to focus on the picture right here. So you see this is your axon, okay? And this is showing you step one of how you make a myelin sheath in the PNS. Now, it is similar in the central nervous system with oligodendrocytes. And I will look at another slide where I show you how it is different, but the way it coils and wraps is pretty similar. So I've got a single over here, I've got a single Schwann cell, and you'll notice right here the nucleus. Now the Schwann cell is gonna come up and it's gonna start grabbing this axon here and it's gonna start wrapping around it. And if you come over here to step two, you will notice that it started to coil, the nucleus gets pushed off to one side, and it's starting to wrap around. Step three, it's wrapped around further. Now notice that again, the nucleus is off to the side. In the tighter rings, what you should notice is that the cytoplasm is getting squished out towards the edges, so that eventually when I come over here to step four, what you will see are many, many coils of the plasma membrane, so the phospholipid bilayer, really tightly wrapped around this axon, very little cytoplasm because most of the cytoplasm has gotten squished out to here, okay? And then that's your nucleus, okay? Now, these phospholipids right here that form the plasma membrane, they basically form the insulation that's going to give the myelin sheath its job, all right? That's gonna do the job of the myelin sheath, which is to basically prevent charged ions from leaking out in this area, okay? It can leak here, but it can't leak where you've got the cell. Now, around the whole thing, you're gonna put a sock on it, and that is your endoneurium, which you should remember is a very delicate CTP, connective tissue proper. All right, next slide. All right, now we're gonna look at oligodendrocytes, and you use this to create the myelin sheath in the central nervous system. All right, same job as the Schwann cells, but structurally it's different. So let's look down here, all right, and I can see my cell body of the oligodendrocyte, and it's got tendrils that are coming away from it. And each tendril is going to wrap around a section of an axon, okay? And it's going to do the same thing with coiling tightly. But what you get then is, if you come over here to this picture, is you get a section of cells that are myelinated, of axons that are myelinated by an oligodendrocyte. In this area right here, you're going to have a different oligodendrocyte, which is going to wrap around these sections, okay? And then over here with number three, this is a scanning electron microscope image, and you can see the cell bodies here, and it's got all these little processes that are coming out and then wrapping around the axons. And so like this one is doing that section, this one is doing that section, this one is doing this section, this one is doing that section, okay? And so one oligodendrocyte will wrap around many axons, but in a clustered area. All right, next slide. So here's another photomicrograph from your APR. And what you can see is an individual Schwann cell and an individual Schwann cell. And then you've got this nice little gap right in here, which is gonna be your node of Ranvier. And you can see they're just kind of stacked up on each other. All right, so this is more notes, but I want to make sure everyone focuses on this a little bit. You've got three major groups or functional classes of neurons. You've got sensory neurons, which are also called afferent, motor neurons, which are also called efferent. I associate the word efferent with exit, so it's exiting the brain and the spinal cord and going to other structures of the body. So this one goes to the brain. This one leaves the brain, okay? Then within the brain, we have interneurons, which are going to be really short neurons that are basically connecting to each other, but also sensory and motor neurons. And it's the bulk of the neurons in the brain are actually interneurons.